that's John. Oh, you just ran over me with the door.
Oh, honey, I'm sorry, but usually you're not standing right in front of the door when I come home.
Well, why don't you look through the peephole to see if I'm looking through the peephole?
Well, honey, if you're just going to stand in front of... Well, Doug, you just ran over me with the door.
Sorry, Dad, people aren't usually standing right there in front of the door.
Well, you should have been looking through the peephole to... Never mind.
Dad, you've met my friend Greg?
Should I? Should I? I should. Praise God. Greg, what are you doing over here?
I was just recruiting for the Solid Rock Hearts of Fire Youth Evangelism Crusade and Boycott Hell Rally. I am the president.
Well, you might as well take Greg on up to the Oval Office.
The Oval Office president. My dad's so funny. Okay, Dad. All right. Let's go.
Honey, I am real excited about this Hearts of Fire Youth Crusade.
Good.
It is going to be great, but we need a lot of help, you know, organizing and planning the meeting, and I was hoping that you'd help.
Well, honey, I don't want you counting on me to get involved in anything that I'm not qualified to do. You know, last time I did that, I ended up with a John the Baptist camel-haired skirt on.
It was a girdle.
A girdle.
Think of it this way, John. Think how many kids are going to get saved, you know, and they're going to make Jesus the Lord of their life. Their mind is going to be renewed.
Yeah, but honey, what's there to it? I mean, you set up the chairs, you turn on the lights, you put a microphone in the preacher's hand and turn him loose. I mean, how much organization and planning does that take?
Oh, without a vision, the people perish. John, just close that paper. Lay your head back here, close your eyes, and envision this now. The world's most exciting and anointed youth minister comes to our town. He is...
Does he have it on a plaid sport coat and a pompadour hairdo?
No, he's got vision wearing an awesome flat top.
Ooh.
Okay, the football field has a platform stage down on the field, and it's full of a praise band. The stadiums are just packed with people.
Greg, as president of the Solid Rock, it's come to my attention that you have neglected in the matters of Helps Ministry.
What's Helps Ministry?
Greg, it's anything that helps ministry. Now, we have a major mammoth Hearts of Fire crusade coming up, and we need help. We need ushers. We need greeters. We need counselors. And, Greg, most of all, we need an audience. Now, what can I put you down for?
The audience. I'll be in the audience.
That's Secret Serviceman Stanley. Hold it right there.
Knock it off, Stanley. Who do you think you are?
CIA, Christian Intelligence Organization. What do you have there, sir?
Hey, this is none of your business. This is mine. I just like to write things, okay?
You know, Greg, you've been going to youth group now for, I don't know, about 20 years. Don't you think it's about time you got evolved?
That's, involved.
That's what I said. Evolved?
How do you, Stanley? I've already covered it with the young man.
Thank you, Doug. I appreciate it. I owe you one.
I got it. Rock Hotline, this is Doug. Yeah, Greg's here. Greg, Hotline. Just 1 minute on the line.
Hello?
Why? What's wrong? Okay. Okay, 4th and Boston. How'd you find me here?
Bye.
Okay. Okay, bye.
Greg, who is that on the hotline?
My dad. He needs me to come home.
Greg, your dad sounds like a girl.
Well, this is my sister. She's calling for my dad. I gotta go.
Just make sure and let us know how you want to get involved by 0800 hours next Wednesday.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll need an organized and fully trained and fully equipped counseling team. One man's job will be to do nothing but handle all the booklets and the tracks and have them at the right place at the right time. Now, write that down.
Okay.
Then we'll need...
Bye, Greg. You coming back tomorrow?
No, I don't think so.
Bye.
Okay, honey, did you get that?
Yes, but are you sure you want to help? I mean, I don't want to drag in anything that you don't want to do.
Are you kidding, Vicky Jo? We're going to see hundreds of kids saved and turned on to Jesus through this crusade.
Doug, I think we need to run a check on that young lad. I'm not sure that he meets up to the qualifications. You know, the one in the book, 1 Timothy, Titus.
I'm sure he does, Stanley.
You know what they say, it's not enough for a president just to be sure. He's got to know that he's sure. Are you sure that you're sure?
Yes, I'm sure. It's you that I'm not sure about. What's this?
I'm not sure. Looks like Greg's diary.
Boys don't have diaries, they have journals.
Looks like Greg's journal. Doug, you're not going to read it. That's classified information.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Well, I'll give it to him tomorrow. I'll see him then.
Are you sure you can read it all in one night?
Sweetheart, we need to talk. Did you bring the money?
Yeah, what's the big emergency?
Come on, let's take a walk. I've got something I need to tell you.
No, you tell me right here. Come on, what's the deal?
I don't know how to say it.
Well, why don't you just open your mouth and let the words come out? Come on, you said it was an emergency.
It's not that easy, Greg.
Well, let me make it easy for you. Go ahead, make my day.
I'm pregnant!
That's it? You're pregnant? Congratulations. Who's the lucky guy this time?
Why do you think I'm telling you? It's yours.
Mine? You're crazy. We're only together once.
Yeah, well, that's all it takes, Greg.
Why are you telling me? You think I care? Hey, I'm a young guy. I got the rest of my life ahead of me. You think I'm going to throw it away just because I got to marry you?
Mary? No one said anything about marrying me. All I want is the $200 to fix my situation.
Well, forget it. I didn't bring the $200 for that. This is your problem. Just can it, Sandy. I'm out of here.
Greg!
What? No.
Tragic, brutal murder of a local teenager. Details next.
Hey, Doug, come on down. Some kid got murdered.
Live on 5, it's the 10 o'clock edition of We Witness News with anchor man Todd Lear.
Sit down.
Meteorologist Scott Brumble.
Listen to this.
Sports with Pete Zeiger. And now, here's Todd Lear.
Thank you. Good evening. Tonight's top story, a 17-year-old local youth was shot and killed around 9 p.m. near the Arkansas River, 4th and Boston area. We have Cam 5 reporter Frank Richardson standing by live near the West Pier. Frank, what's the story down there?
Yes, Todd, a brutal murder did take place just a few feet from where I'm standing, only a couple of hours ago. The victim has been positively identified as 17-year-old Greg Hughes, a Union High School student. No murder weapon has yet been found, but the police said they would conduct a thorough investigation. Details at this point are very sketchy. However, one source has it that robbery may have been a motive in this case. This is Frank Richardson, live from the West Pier for Channel 5 News.
Doug, Greg was here just a few hours ago. What's going on?
I don't know. He got a call. He told me he was going home, Dad.
Doug, he is home. Remember, he's with the Lord.
I can't believe this. I mean, he was just up in my room a few hours ago. And now he's dead. He's gone. murdered.
Why would anybody want to hurt Greg?
I don't know. It's not like we were best friends or anything. I mean, I just knew him from the Rock. That's why I had him over here tonight, is I wanted to get him more involved. Dad, I don't know what's going on. What do you think?
I don't know, son, but there's obviously more to this than meets the eye.
Yeah. They're gonna conduct a full-scale investigation. Do you think that they're gonna want to question Doug?
I don't know.
Why Greg? Lord, why Greg? I can't believe this.
Saturday, June 6th. Tonight I visited a new hangout called Solid Rock, and I did something that I've never done before. I tried to get God in my life. I met this guy, Doug Collins. He's the one that helped me get God. Him and his friend are really different, especially this one guy named Clarence.
Mr. and Mrs. Hughes, I'm sorry about the tragic death of your son, Greg, but the Lord had some mysterious purpose in all of this, I'm sure. I knew Greg well. Greg was a very committed young man.
Thursday, July 4th. Tonight was the best of both worlds. After Joy's celebration at the Solid Rock, I went down to the dock. There was this guy named Jay that had some awesome powder. He told me some wild stories about being locked up for murder one. I didn't believe him. I was more interested in his sister, Sandy. Now there's a girl that is a pro at having fun.
We can comfort one another with the fact that although we feel pain at his departure, he feels none.
This is Officer Palazzo. He'd like to ask you a few questions about Greg. Could we step out in the lobby?
Sure.
Doug, I apologize for having to ask you these questions at this time. But I understand you were with Greg a couple hours before his death. Is that right?
Yeah.
Son, I wonder if you might have any information at all that might help us find who the killer is.
I don't know. You know, maybe.
What happened that day?
Well, this girl just called for Greg, and then he left.
What girl?
Well, all I did is answer the phone, and he talked to her, and then he left. I don't know who it was.
What did he say?
Well, it's like she wanted to get him to leave right away, and he asked why, and then he just hung up and acted like it was his dad that was calling, and then he took off. That's it.
Doug, whoever made that call might possibly know what happened to Greg. If you think of anything, would you give me a call?
Sure.
Thank you.
Doug, what about Greg's journal? Have you read it yet?
Yeah, I read it, Clarence. You'd be surprised at what all is in it.
What, like girls?
Yeah, girls and a whole bunch of other stuff. I don't think we really knew who the real Greg was.
Sunday, January 1st. I have the worst hangover today than I have ever had, but last night was worth it. Didn't get home till 9 this morning. Kathy and Todd were there, and Bobby. I can't believe Bobby beat me at quarters. I'm demanding a recount the next time we're playing with pitchers instead of glasses. Ah, Jay bugged me again about being with Sandy. Nah, he's just blowing. I don't believe he was ever in a gang. I missed church, but I went tonight. I might stop going altogether, though. I feel so guilty. I think I'm going to have to make a choice between going to church and partying. But there's no hurry. I've got plenty of time. In fact, I've got the rest of my life.
I can't believe this.
Book list.
Right, I saw that here just a second ago. No, I put it in here. Right there. I mean, check.
Check. Vicki Jo, when I name an item, if you will just say check, it will expedite everything. Everything will be much more efficient. If you'll just say check.
Okay.
Check.
All right.
Say check.
Okay, check.
Okay.
John, you put so much pressure on me.
Honey, there's a lot of pressure on me. People at the organizational meeting are waiting for me to have everything done and everything ready for them, okay? Now, when I name an item, if you'll just say check.
Okay.
Check.
Job description?
Check.
Okay. Connie, are you ready to go to the meeting?
What meeting?
The Crusade organizational meeting, hon.
Well, I don't think I need to be there. You and Mom are in charge of everything. You can just let me know what I need to do later.
Connie, what if everybody had that kind of an attitude? Honey, you need to go to that organizational meeting so you'll understand the vision of what this whole crusade is about. Connie, we are dealing here with the issue of eternal souls. Honey, you can't just get caught up in your little teenage world and forget that every day people are going to hell in a handbasket. Oh, Connie, what about your little friend Susan down the street?
What about her?
Does she know Jesus? No, of course not. And probably because no one has ever told her that there's a heaven to gain and a hell to shun.
Well, I don't think we need to tell her she's going to hell. Why can't we just love her into the kingdom?
Honey, what your dad's saying is that there really is a hell, and it really is terrifying. And these organizational meetings are important because that way we can get more people to the crusade, and that way more people hear the gospel.
That's right. And Connie, part of that gospel is understanding that Jesus died so we don't have to go to hell.
Well, all right. I just have to go get dressed, and I've got to do something with my hair.
Well, wait then. You're going to need to ride with Doug because we have to go early.
Connie, hair. Rollers. Picture hot rollers in your hair for eternity.
Ooh, Split End City.
All right, Doug, Connie's going to ride to the meeting with you, okay?
Doug, what's wrong?
Can we talk for a minute, you guys?
Is it about Greg? Honey, listen, I want you to know that you're going to go through a gamut of emotions, especially since he was murdered.
Wait a minute. I've got to tell you guys something that I'm really ashamed of.
You know something you didn't tell us? You did something? You killed him? Oh, no, you didn't do that. You only have a BB gun. I'm sorry.
Come on, Doug, what's your story?
Dad, I've got in my hands here Greg's journal. It describes the last 9 months of his life before he was killed, and it's not a pretty story.
His journal? Where'd you get it?
He left it in my room the day he was killed. I guess he forgot it.
What's it say?
Mom, I'm giving it to the police, but basically it describes his life, and it was a double life. I mean, what we saw in church and at the Solid Rock wasn't anything like what we see in here. I mean, we're talking he was into parties and drugs and girls. I mean, bad girls.
Well, that doesn't sound like the life of somebody that's experienced salvation.
But he did. At least I thought he did. He must have. I mean, he prayed the sinner's prayer. But there's no way his heart wasn't right.
So that means right now, Greg's burning.
Hey, everybody, how you doing? I guess I could come back at another time.
Oh, no, Clarence, why don't you come on in and sit down? Talk with Doug. We've got to get to that meeting, John. We'll talk later, Doug. Don't forget Connie.
So I guess your folks know about the journal, huh?
Yeah.
Can I read it?
Sure, Clarence. Talks about you on page 23 right there.
No, they're talking about some guy named Donut Head.
That couldn't be you. I'll get it. Hello. Yeah, this is Doug. Sandy. Oh, yeah, Greg's girlfriend. Yeah, No, he never talked about you. I read about you in his book. Yeah, he had a journal. Well, he left it at my house the day that he was killed. Hey, don't cry. It's okay. Well, yeah, I'd like to talk to you too. See, I have some questions about Greg. Yeah, well, we could meet there if that's where you want to meet. Okay. About 20 minutes? Yeah. Yeah, I'll bring the journal. Okay.
Doug, I hate to mention this, but judging from what I've read in the journal, I'm a little concerned about where Greg may or may not be right now. It says here that he was involved in a lot of things that, well, it's just that most people that do these kind of things go down there, you know? Who's on the phone?
It was Sandy, Greg's girlfriend. She's in there, too.
Yeah, I was reading about her. Isn't she like a runaway? She probably doesn't even brush her teeth.
Yeah, Clarence, and she's really hurting right now. I'm going to just try to encourage her, and I've got some questions I need to ask her.
Well, I don't know. Sounds like bad news to me. I better go with you.
No, Clarence, she asked if I would come alone, okay? Would you please just take Connie to the meeting with Mom and Dad, all right? Let's pray. Father, we just thank you for wisdom that you would give me to speak to Sandy, to encourage her and to help her. And we thank you for your protection. In Jesus' name. Appreciate it. Oh, thanks.
I don't know. Sounds to me like this is a job for the CIA, the Christian Intelligence Organization. Connie, can you get a ride with Stacy? I'm gonna go on.
You must be Sandy. Don't I know you from somewhere?
At the funeral home. Hi, Doug.
Hi.
I wanted you to meet me here because I love Greg so much. And this is the last place that he was alive.
Yeah, I'm really sorry. I've got a lot of unanswered questions about Greg. Did he ever talk to you about Jesus or the Bible, even the solid rock?
Greg? Jesus? The Bible? Man, we must be talking about two different guys.
Yeah, I think we are.
Listen, Doug, it would really mean a lot to me if you would just let me borrow Greg's book just for a few days.
Well, I can let you take a look at it here for a few moments, but I can't let you take it with you.
Oh, come on, Doug. Couldn't you just let me borrow it, like, for one night, just for a night?
No, I can't. I've got to give it to the police in the morning. There's a lot of names in here, and one of these people might know who killed Greg. You were really close with him, weren't you?
She was, but I wasn't.
Jay! I thought you said you'd let me handle this alone.
Shut up.
Jay, your brother? Sandy, you were the one that called Greg the night that he got killed, weren't you?
That's gonna be our little secret, isn't it, kid? Give her the book.
now.
Okay, take the book. I don't want it. I gotta go. It's been nice seeing you guys.
Hold on. Get back here. You're not going anywhere. Nowhere but hell.
No, not again.
Wait a minute. I'm chasing a killer. This is not good. Thank you for your wisdom, Lord. Clarence, wait. We're gonna call the police. Come on.
Sam, thanks. Yes, we understand that the arraignment date's in 2 weeks. Right. Doug? He's right here, safe and sound. Yeah, they've got Sandy and Jay locked up in custody. They just want Doug to testify in the arraignment hearing, and we'd like you to represent him, if you would, please. Super. Thanks, Sam. Bye-bye.
Okay, tell us that part about the gun. I want to hear that.
Okay, there I was, face to face with one of the 10 most wanted criminals in America.
Sure.
Okay, he was in the top 40. But I did my double pump drop kick, probably about 4.5 feet off the ground. After I began...
Doug, sit down, son. Your story's turned into a miniseries. We are proud of you, though.
Dad, I was just wondering, how many people are there in the world like Greg who go to youth group or go to church week after week, but they never really give their lives over to Jesus?
You know, Connie, Jesus talked about people like Greg in the parable of the sower. He said some people would receive the word of God fully into their heart, and the word would bear fruit 30, 60, and 100-fold. But other people, the word of God would be choked by the deceitfulness of sin and the deceitfulness of riches.
Well, I'm ready to go to work on that crusade. It's just selfish to be embarrassed to invite somebody. I've got to get Susan to that meeting so she doesn't end up like Greg.
That's great. Just too bad that some people don't find out until it's too late. And then there's nothing you can do.
Sunday, May 28th. Dear Greg, so what's it like? Is it everything you thought it would be? Or did you really ever give it that much thought at all? Probably not. Most people our age don't. I can't even begin to imagine the hell that you're experiencing right now. And Bud, that flame will never go out. I've learned a lot of things in the last few weeks, Greg. One of them is that death can be very sudden. Can come without any warning at all. And another one is that you just don't gamble with eternity. It's the only game that you can lose forever. Oh, and by the way, if it's any consolation to you, I promise to do all that I can to keep everyone I know from joining you. Farewell.
Most people don't find out till it's too late that someone has to pay the price. You can pay it yourself or let someone else, but who would be that nice to pay a debt that isn't his? Well, I know someone like that, and he's your best friend. He really people don't find out till they're half dead that they need another life. You say you've heard everything that's ever been said about the way, the truth, the life. You say you've heard lots of preaching all before, so many times. But did you ever open up your door, give him a chance to prove himself? But he's real, no. I hope you find out before it's too late that there's really nobody. But I pray if I die.